I would like to welcome you to the world of Push TV.
Are you ready for the comedy? Episode so good, it feels like an anomaly. Showtime is a star. It's Push TV, no TV. Welcome to the world of Push TV. If it isn't Showtime, who would he be? Welcome to the world of Push TV. Welcome to the world of Push TV. Welcome to the world of Push TV. If it isn't Showtime, who would he be? Welcome to the world of Push TV. Welcome to the world of Push TV.
I bet that you'll laugh. Hunches. Your sister, brother, cousin, daddy, and mama do want this. You don't want to miss none of the comical punches that'll make you bust the good like abdominal crunches.
Ow. You must be watching Push TV. If it wasn't Showtime, who else would he be? It begins in no time, so would we see. Tune in, take a seat, welcome to Push TV.
On the microphone. We're here at the Halloween party. I would like to thank our guests for inviting us. We're all having a good time, we're enjoying ourselves. It's your boy Provide, Push TV's in the building. Right now we're gonna have a costume contest. The judge is the DJ. So if you don't win, that's who we attack tonight. So, I'm gonna invite you guys up one by one. Of course, I'm a doctor. I specialize in astrology. I went to Harvard for 2.5 years. Nice chocolate. Very milky. But I'm gonna bring everybody else up. I want you to come up, introduce yourself, tell us what you are, and then go around, and then we'll do one at a time. So first of all, I want to bring up one of my favorites, because she's an alumni from the EC. Special. I got a cheerleader coming to the building. Let's go. Come on. Come on, baby. Let's go. We got a cheerleader. Come on up, man. Basketball player. Let's go. I want you to tell everybody in a Push TV land what your name is, and what you are, and what your costume is. Let's go.
My name is Rachel, and I am a blue gold cheerleader.
Hey! Everybody give up for Rachel. She is a blue gold cheerleader. My man?
My name is Pete, and she rules the roost, so I guess I'm a blue gold basketball player.
All right, that means you heard me say he don't wear the pants, she do. So he's a basketball player, I guess. Next, ma'am, excuse me, can I talk to you, please? Thank you.
Hold on, I gotta get the rest of my power.
I'm a crank.
Oh, hold on, my man gotta come up. We got a surprise for you. We got a real special guest in the building. Justin Timberlake is here. You've seen his video. You can't see this because this is a family-friendly show, but my man has a gift wrap box around his, you dig. It's something called something in a box. That's a hint. So, tell him what your name is, man.
Joel.
And he has a surprise for you. If you want to see what's in the box, holler.
Would anybody like to look in my box?
Hey, everybody already looked in there except for me. I can't go that way. All right, Joel, let's go. Who's next? Oh, we need to talk to the clergy in the building. Come on up. We got the clergy in the building. Come on up. They about to pray for Push TV tonight.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Introduce yourself and tell us what you are.
Hey there, I'm Kristen. I'm a Bible banger.
Bible
love
banger.
Jesus.
Woo!
Yes.
Bible banger.
My name is Paul, and I prefer Bible beater.
So we got a Bible banger and a Bible beater. I ain't never heard of it, but guess what? They are in the running. Let's go. They're praying for Push TV tonight. They're all over the land. Let's go. All right, thank you guys for coming up. Who's next? Okay, we got a let's get my comrades from work up here. We got a doctor and a nurse in the building. Why don't y'all step up and introduce yourselves?
You're up.
My
name is Cindy.
Let's go. Push TV in the building. Halloween party. Let's go. Introduce yourself and tell us what your costume is.
Say, I'm a nurse.
Cindy, I'm a nurse. Can you speak up? Push TV land can't hear you.
Cindy, I'm a nurse.
All right. Cindy's a nurse.
I'm Brian, I'm a plastic surgeon.
Plastic surgeon, so if your face messed up, you need to holler at my man.
Show me your
card! Or if you want my card.
Oh, if you got the card, hold on, let me step up. You gotta see this. That's a free breast exam. Push TV in the building. Okay, who's next? Okay, we got your favorite fruit in the building. Let's go, banana. Oh, wait a minute, we got a... I'm a ventriloquist, and this is my dummy. What's your name? She doesn't speak too well. Hold on, let me try.
My name is Dumbman. Thank you.
Did you see my lips? I didn't do any job. I'm trying. I'm really not a ventriloquist, I'm a doctor. Anyways, thank you for coming on up. Next! Alright, y'all already know what's next. Man, your favorite fruit. Everybody love bananas.
Everybody!
Give it up for the banana man. So, I want you to introduce yourself and I want you to tell me when the last time you had a banana split.
Tonight, and my name is Paul. And by the way, you already gave it up. I'm a banana.
You are a banana. Can you peel? Can somebody peel and get to the
it's very appealing.
The middle part?
It's definitely possible I can be peeled and definitely gonna get to the middle part.
Should they peel you from the
What's
top
your
or the bottom?
Fear?
No, definitely the bottom.
Hey, ladies, you heard it. Peel from the bottom. Let's go. And I just want to let y'all know, y'all seeing the clergy up here. I already talked to Jesus tonight. We got an angel in the building. Let's go. Push TV's in the building. She fell all the way from the skies.
Yeah,
from
angel.
Me. Push TV. Tell her what your name is.
I'm Lori.
Lori's in the building. She fell all the way from heaven for me. Ain't that something? Hey, God works in mysterious ways, don't he?
She's going to peel a banana.
Oh, this the one that's going to peel a banana? Oh, man. What kind of angel is that? Okay. All right. Oh, the zealots. Oh, this is great. Hey, check this out. Y'all don't know. I don't even know. I'm speechless right now. We got a star in the building. I know you've seen the commercials. Mayhem. He will fall on your car. He will bust your windows. He will hide in your dark spot right here. We got my man in the building, Mayhem, from the insurance commercial. Won't you tell us your name? You heard it. He said his name is Mayhem. And what do you do?
I'm a hot chick.
Oh, a hot chick jogging along the road. And somebody crashed. Ain't that something? Ain't that something?
I'm out making sure this is always a 10.
Oh, look at this here. Y'all give it up in the building, my man. Mayhem is in the building.
So my girlfriend's coming over to tan. Set up a little surprise for her. Show her what happens if you tan too long.
So, time to do a little scaring. There's some balls there. Some kneecaps.
Attention, all you. Do you want to be noticed? Sign up for the 2011 Youth Talent Showcase sponsored by the Push Foundation. Saturday, December 10th at the Harmony Cafe, 1660 West Mason Street, Green Bay. Visit pushtv.webs.com for more information or pushfoundation.webs.com to sign up. Age ranges are from 5 to 18 years old, and the program is from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. We need you. Want to see you there, want to see your talents. Peace.
You. Do it matter where I'm from, if
from spitting hot flame. If I repped on the east, would my flow sound the same? If I repped down south, dirty in my ways, gold in my mouth, mug on my face. If I repped on the west, bouncing like a 6'4", hyphy with my diss face, seeing what they hitting for.
What if I rep that Midwest, though?
Midwest, though.
Yeah.
I'm going hard in the paint. Malone, no jazz, more like Moses. Flow game ferocious. Pre-game attitude, my drop like a Olajuwon. Post-game deadly, this is just the middle. Mealtown buck boy, like B. Jennings. But I'm about 6'3", this is the beginning. Codename Alpha, smash like Amari Stoudemire. Stand down if you're not spitting fire. Enough for the name drops, rain, no raindrops. Oh, that was easy. Yes, I'm Khaleesi, Coach K mentality. Every day is game time, listen twice a day. We working on the same grind. Big stack Benjamin, I'm starting center. You can build a team around me. Certified winner, yeah, them boys getting quap. This much more than local. This is vision bifocal. That mean it's money over here, money over there, money everywhere. I'm the network, so let's get it. Yeah. And your boys running slow with it. I'm about to change, understand, I'm about to go get it. Yeah, I'm about to go get it. Yeah, I'm about to go get it. Yeah, I'm about to go get it.
Peace.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe.
Peace. Please welcome back to Push TV. This is the Roundtable Discussion, and I am Showtime.
And I am Big M.
It's your boy Pro Vox, the ECA affiliate. You know what it is.
Man, what's going on, man? We want to say what's up to all our Eau Claire fans, though, man. Y'all been watching the show now for a couple weeks. We need to get some responses from y'all on these roundtables now. Come on, EC. Y'all can do it now.
Get up, man.
I believe in you. So what's up, man? Hit them off with the topic, man.
And today's topic is, you know what I'm saying, your choice of friends, picking friends.
Right, man. I'm telling you, it's a lot more important than you think at the time.
Because it sounds simple because everybody's friendly. So just because you're friendly with somebody, and you need to learn the difference between an associate and a friend.
Man, that's a good point.
You know what I'm saying? Like, because a lot of people are like, oh, that's just my friend, and use the term loosely. You know what I'm saying? And everybody ain't your friend. Until you find out who your friend is, need something like $150. Now, a friend is who you can go ask that for that $150.
Right.
An associate is somebody like,
I ain't got it.
Not to say like your friend ain't gonna be like, ain't got it either, but you know what I'm saying? Like, right. You know you can ask that person. You can at least ask. You know you feel comfortable asking that person, and that person gonna be running around like, that nigga Showtime asked me for $150.
He broke.
He got it.
So what's up, man? Big M, man, we want to hear from you, man. What's up, man? You know, you were one of the ones who was pointing out this topic, man. Why don't you tell the viewers out here, especially some of the youth, man, about, you know, the importance of choosing friends, man.
You are who you hang out with. You might be different from your friends. They could be smoking weed, drinking, and all that. You don't have to do that stuff. But when people look at your friends and you're with them, that's you. You are judged by who the company you keep.
Right.
So
right.
You choose your friends wisely.
That's a good point, because a lot of chicks hang out with those other girls.
Man, them girls
know what we talking about. And they're like, I ain't like them. Well, that's who you hang with.
Like,
what you think the guys that see them other girls and they know what they do, they won't assume you do the same thing.
Man, that's
and you can't be mad at them for saying it, because they like you. Well, you will.
Now this coming from a male. Now this is a male perspective. Seriously, so man. You and your friends might be like, oh, no, girl, they don't think that. Yes, we do.
Yeah. And then they go for guys, too. Like, we hang around with us and we walking out or thugs and drug dealers. You know what? They might be looking at us like, he's a thug. He ain't got nothing going on with himself. Right. That's what we hanging out with. Right. So be careful. Like, make sure you got a variety of different kind of people that you hang out with. You know what I'm saying? Be understanding. Like, stay close to the block. Keep your foot on the block. But at the same time, realize that you can also be a professional, hang out with that crowd. And also, make sure you just pick your friends wisely so you're hanging out with a good group of people. So they're just, in general, good people.
Right. I mean, one of the oldest things that people say, man, birds of a feather flock together. You know, one of the things that me and Pro always talk about, man, when choosing your friends as well, make sure you choose friends, you know, that can help you up your game or help you move forward in life, man. Because if you hang out with a bunch of people that's not even on your level, you know, how are you going to know, you know, that you're supposed to keep progressing? Because if you better than all your friends,
I'm trying to help y'all out. I'm up in y'all game, but ain't nobody helping me out over here.
Right.
And positive things happen to positive people. So if you're hanging with positive people, then positive things will happen to you. Hanging with negative people, negative things going to happen to you.
And you can't be mad, be like, man, I can't believe that happened when I was with someone. So, well, you know his reputation, so that's why you got punched in the head when they were trying to hit
him. He ducked.
That's your fault. He got good reflexes.
You know, if you're riding around with your friend and he got drugs on him and you don't have nothing, you still got something to worry about.
You're
going to jail right with him.
Good point.
Right, no, you definitely going to jail, because the police ain't going to be like, oh, one of y'all getting, which one of it is it? No, y'all both going to jail. Right. They don't take no time to figure out who car it is. Nah, y'all going to jail tonight. Y'all going to jail tonight, both of y'all.
Felons.
A message to all the kids out there, you know, coming directly from the Push Foundation. One of the things we teach is that the decisions you make today can affect you for the rest of your life. That includes the friends that you choose, man. So let's keep that in mind. So, man, we want to hear from y'all, you know, because, you know, it's not always easy to tell a person. Like, how do you really tell a person? It ain't like Facebook where you can just unfriend somebody.
Who's accidentally unfriended you?
How do you tell a person, like, I don't think you're the best friend for me, or I don't think this friendship is working out? You know, how do you really say that, you know? So, you know, I know it's not always easy, you know, but, you know, it's definitely something that you need to do.
I, for one, got a lot of different ways you can tell somebody.
We ain't talking about just flipping them off and running either.
I got a lot of ways. If you want to offend somebody, I got a way. If you don't want to offend them, I got a way.
See, we figure it out.
Yeah, but, see, because he got a bad habit of just erasing people's number out of his phone.
Like, so when you text him and he say, who this?
Yeah, I'm not your friend.
I ain't friend no more.
You got it registered. Chances are. But like you said, it's very important for the kids to start out learning this lesson early so that when they grow up and they go through that maturation process, they will understand the importance of picking a good friend. So if you start early, then you ain't got to worry about picking bad friends when you're older because you started at a young age. So it's nice to just tone that into them right now and let them know that we can start early so you ain't got to worry about, you know, saying picking horrible friends later on in life.
Right.
Start early.
And who wants to be 30 years old and friend out, find out that all their friends are bums?
What am I doing? Oops, I grew up with all these people, these same people, man.
No, but that's a good point, man. I'm glad you brought that up, man, on a serious note, for real. So y'all out there, man, TV land, man, make sure y'all get us, because we love to hear from y'all. Y'all can send us a text message to 920-397-4427 right there.
Or you can hit us up at PushTVAtLive.com. We'd love to hear from you. Again, if the feedback is good, like I said, you might hear it on the next show. We definitely like to hear some stories on how you became friends with somebody or how you had to let a friend go because of negativity or things like that. So just hit us up, man. Let us know. We need your feedback. Again, it can't be around the table discussion without you.
Yep.
So we need.
Or you might see us out on the street. Stop us. Talk to us.
Oh, yeah. Holla at you, man.
All about that.
Holla at me. Holla at me. We be down on Water Street when we in Eau Claire. When we in Green Bay, we be down on Washington Street and a little bit of everywhere. But I do have some complaints about the nightlife in Green Bay, but that's for another topic.
So, well, we definitely gonna talk about that soon. Real soon.
Real soon. That's so we gonna get up out of here, man. We wanna hear from y'all. Until next time, stay busy and push positive.
Yeah!
It's a bird, it's a plane. It's the Not So Super Superhero Squad.
Oh no, my pecker party's tonight and I forgot to text all of my friends. Have no fear, Bone Girl is here. Oh no, it's insane! I have another. Done. Thanks, Foam Girl!
I want to go outside, but I can't go until all my food is done.
This is what I need job for. Greedy boys!
Oh no! This room is uncharacteristically clean. There's only one man who can stop that problem. Dirty Man! The dirtiest man alive!
It's a bird, it's a plane. It's the Not So Super Superhero Squad.
Okay, it's the time of the night where we announce who's about to win the best costume prize for Push T out there in Push TV land. Right now, we're gonna count down from 3 to 1. Remember, whoever does not win, we jump into DJ, so it don't matter. It's all gonna be a good time. So, DJ, I need you to tell you right now, who's got the number 3 costume in the building?
Oh, I don't know.
Number 3.
As a pair.
Oh,
the priest.
All right, we got the clergy. It's number 3. Come on up, clergy. Let's go. You got to give it up for Jesus.
Jesus! 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 Jesus!
All right, number 3. We got a prize waiting for you over here at the table. It's called a shot. Oh, come on now. We got the D in the box. Let's go. It's a TV show, but he's got a package for you, number 2. You know, it is what it is. So tell me how you feeling. There's a lot of pressure out there. A lot of people trying to take your title. How you feeling?
There's a lot of pressure in my box.
Really?
So I didn't really notice anybody else.
So you didn't notice anybody because there's a lot of pressure in your box? Okay, and now for the awaited moment. Who's got the number 1? I can tell you right now, I think it's me, but I can't win because of my show, so I can't rig it like that because that's just wrong, even though I'm the doctor of D. So, DJ, break it down for me right now. Who's got the number 1 costume in the building?
All right, first I got to say we've got a runner-up first place winner. Because hot chicks rolling, I've never voted on a contest and not had it be a female winner, and this time it's going to be a non-female. But we gotta bring the ladybug up just because hot chicks are rolling.
Yeah! Ladybug!
Uh-oh, here come the ladybug. Here come the ladybug.
The ladybugs in the building, let's go. Push TV in the building. Come on.
I don't like bugs till now.
I like your style, man. I like your flavor. I like your flavor, neighbor. I like your flavor. All right. Let's get to the business. Let's get to the number one prize. Celebration. Celebration. Give it up, DJ.
I didn't know what his costume was, and I already thought that was him. Mayhem.
Number one in the building, let's go. You seen the commercial. Your boy, oh, look, he's jogging up. Mayhem is in the building. Y'all give it up for my man, Mayhem. Mayhem is in the building. You won. So, Mayhem, you tell me right now, since we all are adults in this building right now, we all have insurance. Are you going to avoid us tonight?
Absolutely not.
Oh, so you're going to ruin our lives. Thank you, Mayhem, for winning the prize and ruining everybody's lives tonight at the Halloween costume.
Prize?
Number one, hey, you know what? How are you feeling, champ? I mean, I knew the whole time you were sitting under your sweat and you was thinking like, nobody can take my title. What were you feeling? What was going through your head when he announced your name?
I'm looking for a disaster. I'm looking for an accident.
See? You can't even get out of character. You can't get out of character right now. Again, the costume party, the prize goes to Mayhem, number one in the building. Let's get the trophy. I need you to walk up to the camera and give him a close-up of the number one trophy. And he got a kiss from the ladybug because he's number one. Ain't that something? Ain't this something?
Thank your wife.
All right, man, come over here real quick. We gotta end this. We gotta do this real quick. You got any shout outs you wanna give out to Push TV World? Anybody out there watching, mom, dad, uncles, nephews, wife, anybody, give a shout out.
Everybody. I got you covered.
Your wife.
You heard what he said?
Because you don't want me to.
Mayhem's in the building. Again, check us out. Push TV's in the building. www.pushtv.web.com. It's your boy, Provok. I'm walling out. I'm about to enjoy myself. I'm about to go see if the ladybug let me get a kid. And the other nurses and everybody here, the angels, everybody. I need to get something. Everybody got to give me something. Celebration. Push TV in the building. Holla at your boy. We in here. Peace.